it's Friday morning. You try to access your favorite social media app, but it's not working. You decide to read the news instead. But hey, none of your favorite sites are loading. You open a browser to ask the internet, is this site down for everyone? Then you start hearing from others. Friends and colleagues reach out. It's not only you that can't visit these sites. Everyone has the same issue. How could this be? Welcome to another episode of Once Upon an Attack, a web series by the Splunk Education team in which we learn about common cybersecurity threats and attacks. Today, we'll talk about denial of service, or DOS. DOS attacks aim to make a service, machine, or network inaccessible for its intended users by overwhelming its capacity with requests. At a small scale, it could be a TCP SYN flood attack, where a user sends enough synchronized packets to exhaust the available ports a server has to provide a response. A DOS can also be accomplished using crafted packets that target known vulnerabilities that cause a service or server to completely crash. Most public services expect to be the target of these attacks, and therefore have a certain level of protection against them. But this, of course, has caused DOS attacks to evolve into distributed DOS attacks, or DDoS, which rely on robot networks or botnets. Botnets are composed of infected devices, sometimes referred to as zombies, that have been hijacked by a malicious actor. Once infected, these devices can either phone home to a command and control server, or CC, which can also be called C2 or CNC, or just wait for further instructions. Botnets can be controlled by a centralized CC server, or by a tiered network of CC servers. Some may even use peer-to-peer or P2P communication to stay in control. Because why have your CC server be the single point of failure of your attack? Bots can be anywhere in the world. Botnet attacks are very hard to shut down because the attack is coming from literally everywhere. Botnets can be hundreds of thousands of bots in size, making them perfect for successful DOS attacks against targets with robust security. But they can also be useful in other types of malicious activity. For example, botnets have been used to launch brute force attacks aimed at account takeover, to send spam, as well as for mining cryptocurrency, all without the owners realizing their machine's processing power is being redirected to other tasks. But back to our main story. A botnet was involved in a 2016 incident that left many of us feeling like the internet was down. This happened when a malware known as Mirai was released into the world by its creators. This malware targeted devices which are part of what we call the Internet of Things, or IoT. This term includes almost any physical item that can connect to the internet, from medical devices, refrigerators, network routers, security cameras, vehicles, even your washing machine, you name it. Mirai would search for IoT devices that ran a stripped-down version of Linux OS and kept their default username and password, then logged in and gained control of the device. Mirai-infected devices are believed to be a big part of the several thousands of hijacked IoT devices that targeted the domain name system, or DNS provider, DIN, on October 21st, 2016. Why attack a DNS provider? Whenever you type a URL on your browser to visit a website, your computer sends a domain name resolution request to translate that URL to an actual IP address. If your DNS is unable to return that IP address to you, like it happened during the attack, then you cannot reach that website, even if it's actually up and running. At least three waves of attacks were launched against DIN's DNS services, lasting from early morning to end of business day US Eastern Time on a Friday, affecting DNS responses and making many major websites unavailable for users across North America and Europe, giving many of us the feeling that the internet was down. Back then, it was considered the largest attack of its kind, and unfortunately, it has not been the last massive DDoS attack we have seen. As recently as June 2023, Microsoft reported a Layer 7, or application-level DDoS attack against some of their services. While Microsoft was able to tune their web application firewall rules and mitigate the attack, the alleged attackers are believed to still have a large collection of bots and tools they can operate. They now rely on cloud services and open proxy infrastructures to do so. An unforeseen side effect of expanding our digital footprint to the cloud? There are simply more potential hosts to compromise and hijack. So why would anyone want to launch a denial of service attack? Malicious actors can have different motivations to bring a service down. They may want to make a statement against a service, company, individual, or even a government. They might want to impact a business's revenue. How can a business operate if their main services are down? They may want to distract from other malicious activities. Or maybe they just want to see if they can do it. DOS situations do not always occur from a malicious attack. Take, for example, a flash sale at an online e-commerce store. This may result in an overwhelming amount of traffic for a site that is unprepared for that kind of volume. Either way, denial of service hits directly at one of the principles of security, which is availability. Companies should have strategies to protect their critical services against these types of attacks, including correct sizing and growth planning. Implementing technologies that can help them control the load and tools that let them and their teams and analysts catch anomalies quickly so they can respond faster to those incoming threats. To learn more about these types of attacks and how Splunk can support your efforts against them, visit the links in the description below. For getting started guides and product tips, please visit Splunk Lantern. We also suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, and register for courses from Splunk Education. Once Upon an Attack was brought to you as part of our Blue Team Academy Cybersecurity Defense Analyst program. Thanks for watching.